Hi, welcome to this How Do I video in the extension series, in which we will show you how to build a basic Microsoft Dynamics NAV extension. At the end of this video, I'll have created an extension similar to the extension that was built in the video How Do I Get Introduced with Building Microsoft Dynamics NAV Extensions on the Azure Demo. But now, we will only use the commandlets that come with the product. This means we will create an extension in the most basic way possible. We will do this in three easy steps. First, we'll go over some prerequisites, what we need to complete this video. Next, we will create a NAVX file from the customizations that we have done. And finally, we will test this extension in our test environment. This video is based on a previous How Do I video in the extension series, namely the How Do I Build My Own Development Environment for Starting to Develop Microsoft Dynamics NAV Extensions. If you didn't see this video yet and followed instructions there, please do so now. This means we have an isolated environment to start with an original, dev, and test instances. Let's have a look at the customizations I have done on the dev environment. Basically, we have added a field item classification on the item table, which is calculated by an action on the item list, and by code in the code unit calc item classification method. What the extension exactly does is not important for the content of this video. What is important, though, is how to turn this into an extension. So, let's dive into that. First thing we need to do is export the original objects. But before we do that, we need to load the modules that we will need and create a working folder where we will export objects and save the resulting NAVX file. Now, let's export the original text files. We obviously need to do this once, as long as the original is not changing. The exported text file is fine to use for creating deltas. Next, we need to export our developed objects. It's always advised to export all objects, so this is what we will do now. As you can see, two files were created. It's now time to compare them and create the deltas for our extension. The next thing we need is the manifest. The manifest basically describes the extension, like who is the author, a small description, prerequisites, things like that. So, let's create a manifest for this extension. The script is going to take into account that if the manifest file already exists, that is going to take that manifest. It is important to keep the app ID generated by the new Nav App manifest commandlet. You should never change the app ID during the lifecycle of your extension, because that would disturb things like data, archive, and such. Now we have all the bits we minimally need to create the extension, the manifest and the deltas. So, let's use the new Nav App package to create the NavX file and point to the resources that we just created. There we go. The NavX file is created. This is our extension. Let's now test our extension in our test environment. To make an extension available on certain system, you need to publish it. When it's available, you can install it to a certain tenant. On a single tenant environment, like our test environment, you can install it to the tenant default. So, first thing we do is execute the publish NAV app commandlet. Now the app is being tested, the deltas are being applied, and the corresponding metadata tables are being filled, so that the NST knows what to do when the extension is being installed in a certain tenant. Let's do that next. Let's execute the install NavApp commandlet to make it available in our default tenant. We can now open the Windows client of our test environment to test our extension. Let's open the item list. And yes, our field item classification is there, as is our new action, which basically means that the extension has been made available successfully. In this video, you have seen the basic steps you need to take to create and test a Microsoft Dynamics NAV extension. You can find more info on extensions in the Dynamics Learning Portal with the link that I provided here. Thanks for watching, and see you soon in another How Do I video from the Microsoft Dynamics NAV extension series.